Hey everyone, welcome back. It's Jyoti.
And Shruti, what's up, Joe?
I'm still floating in the messy
Yeah,
of
same.
Harkali. And I was thinking this, we were talking just now offline, guys, and thinking how like the souk and the whole marketplace, sort of the set they've shown us, it reminded me of the old souk in Muscat where I've grown up. And like traditionally, people like people all these things are very part of even the traditions and culture. That's all so like connected and
Similar,
similar, you know, like the Omanis are sitting and wearing their traditional clothes. The men and women, they're dressed in their own ways, and there's bukhur burning एक जगह वही इतर की दुकान है, एक जगह दूसरी सिल्वर की दुकान है और ज्वेलरी की दुकान है. सो इट्स ऑल
And
वेरी
crystals,
कनेक्टेड. या द होल वर्ल्ड इज सो लाइक यू नो द सिमिलैरिटीज आर प्रोबेबली मोर देन डिफरेंसेज इफ यू रियली लुक एट इट. हाँ, बट विद दैट थॉट लेट्स गेट इन टू द मैजिकल जर्नी.
Yes,
रेडी?
ready.
चलो 1 2 3 प्ले.
लाइव रिकॉर्डिंग चल रही है सर।
बहुत आला।
ये मतलब ये तो एक रिकॉर्ड मिस भी है जिसमें आपको नजर आएगा कि 25-30 लोगों ने बस टेबल को उठाया जस्ट टू डॉक्यूमेंट रिकॉर्ड। ये इनका तरीका।
ये बात पहुंचना लोगों तक जरूरी है कि यार ये भी पाकिस्तान है ना, तो देख लो
ये इनके जज्बात है
ये
जो
इनके
ये
जज्बात
पहुंचे
है।
हुए
यस यस यस
रिकॉर्ड करने।
उसकी वीडियो भी बन रही है, उसके अंदर भी ये विजुअल इन्फॉर्मेशन है एंड वी आर क्रिएटिंग दीज मोमेंट्स।
पठान जो है, पश्तून जो है, वो बहुत आर्ट और म्यूज़िक के शैदाई लोग हैं और ये चीज़ें हमने अपने एरिया लकी मरवत में देखी है। उस ज़माने में JVC या नेशनल या पैनासोनिक के टेप रिकॉर्ड, दो ब्लैक स्पीकर्स लगे होते थे सिल्वर कलर के, वो लोग जो है ना अपने दुम्बे बकरे बेच के लेते थे।
We found out that a lot of things that were ingrained in our heads were completely false. The kind of pictures that they were bringing up from different cultures, it was insane. It opened our vision so much.
So, गाने का narrative है, it's about you know one world welcoming the other, right? But this is us talking to the world. कि बेशक हम फर्क हैं आपसे, तो अच्छी बात है फर्क है, लेकिन हमारे दिल के दरवाजे आपके लिए खुले हुए हैं। ज़हूर, ज़हूर इज़ अ पश्तो आर्टिस्ट फ्रॉम मर्दान। सो जो नैरेटिव है वो एक्चुअली बिल्कुल फिट इन भी कर रहा है, टाई इन भी कर रहा है विद द विद द विद द रियलिटीज ऑफ द सिचुएशन।
मेरा कल्चर क्यों लैग बैक कर रहा है और कल्चर के हिसाब से ग्लोबल जितने भी कल्चर्स हैं वो किस तरह से मतलब ऑपरेट करते हैं, दुनिया उसको किस तरह से चेरिश करती है, हम क्यों बेचारे हैं भाई। हमें साबित नहीं करना, हमें उस चीज को ओन करके इस तरह से सेलिब्रेट करना है कि लोग भी उसे देखें कि यार ये कल्चर तो हम कुछ और समझ रहे थे, तो कुछ और है। हमारी जो हिस्ट्री है बींग अ पख्तून, इट्स सो रिच। हमारे कल्चर में कितना सरकैज़म है, हमारे कल्चर में कितनी सेलिब्रेशंस हैं, हमारे कल्चर में कितना फन है और साथ में हमारे कल्चर में कितना रिस्पेक्ट है। मुझे पता नहीं था कि भाई ओरिजिनल्स कैसे बनाते हैं, कवर्स करता था मैं यूनिवर्सिटीज़ में। हमारे सीनियर्स बहुत ज़्यादा रैगिंग करते थे, सीनियर्स से बचने के लिए मैं उन्हें कहता था मैं एक आर्टिस्ट हूँ, मुझे गाने गाने आते हैं। Rokiam zapach pal dunya ke nasta walam stap kwa ke ona Lafzuna release nahi hua tha us time pe, mujhe bilkul andaaza hi nahi tha ki ek bande ko ek gana bhi pasand aata hai aur mera gana। और वहाँ से फिर एक महीना गुजर गया, दो महीना, उसकी एक हाइप बिल्ड होनी स्टार्ट हुई और फिर रेंडमली मुझे जुल्फी भाई का मैसेज आया।
जो मैंने अपने दिमाग में एक पश्तो मेलोडीज और आइडियाज और बीट्स और ग्रूव्स का एक कॉन्सेप्ट था, पता चला कि नहीं देयर इज अ वे टू डू इट इन विच इट कैन जस्ट बी समथिंग एल्स बट स्टिल रियल। मुझे वो बंदा, वो एलिमेंट नजर आ गया कि जिसके थ्रू हम ये कर सकते हैं। ज़हूर गेव मी दैट एक्साइटमेंट, सो आई रियलाइज देन नाउ वी कैन बिल्ड, नाउ वी कैन बिल्ड अ नैरेटिव, सो आई जस्ट मैसेज्ड हिम।
Wow.
मेरे करियर का सबसे बड़ा हिस्सा पिशावर है, सबसे ज़्यादा मेलेडीज पिशावर से ही निकली है, पिशावर के ढाबों से निकली है, पिशावर के कावे की दुकानों से निकली है। पेखावर जाऊँगा कोर दे, तो एम कोर जाऊँ पेखावर दे। इट्स लाइक पेशावर इज आर सेकेंड होम, हर एक पठान उसे घर समझता है।
यहाँ पे पेशावर में तो सब कुछ स्पेशल है, पेशावर के खाने स्पेशल है, लोग स्पेशल है, पेशावर का अपना एक एसेंस है।
मैं और उस्मान जब आते हैं ना तो ज़्यादातर यहाँ पे मोहल्लों में ही घूमते हैं, यहाँ के लोगों के जो डायलेक्ट्स होते हैं, यहाँ पे जो खाने मिलते हैं वो खुद में एक इंस्पिरेशन होती है, जैसे मेलोडीज बनती है,
बहुत सारी वीडियोस, बहुत सारी चीज़ें, इवन बिजनेसेस बहुत बड़े बड़े हम यहाँ पे प्लान करते हैं।
ये सराउंडिंग के मेरे गली मोहल्लों के लोग हैं जिनके साथ मैं सलाम करता हूँ, मेरे साथ बच्चे गुजरते हैं, ढाबों पे बैठता हूँ, वहाँ पे जो लोग बातें करते हैं उन्हीं से मेरा म्यूजिक निकलता है।
You're toxic, I'm slipping under with the taste of your poison.
Mera naam Rahma hai. I'm from Los Angeles. I've been making music since I was 14. You know that you're toxic.
Yeah, yeah. Hi.
मेरी उर्दू अच्छी नहीं है, टूटी फूटी है। सब कुछ समझती हूँ मगर इतनी अच्छी नहीं बोलती हूँ।
This is our first time meeting.
There's a lot of miles gone into this meeting as well. And over here, miles.
By the end of the song, na, Rahma is singing in Pashto as well. उसको पश्तो थोड़ी ट्रेनिंग देनी है, ज़रूर और हिदायत भी है तेरे लिए।
I'm about to sing in Pashto before I sing in Urdu, but it's fine. I'll do it though.
Nashma dizo.
I'm better. I can't read it.
Nashma dizo.
Nashma
dizo.
Nashma dizo. When I first heard the song, I thought there are ways that I could really compliment this song in a way that most people probably can't, because it's in English and it's a different perspective. It's a different world that I grew up in, but it's still the same feeling.
हम ऐसे ही बात करें कि दो लोग हैं जो कि एक दूसरे की लैंग्वेज नहीं बोलते, बट दे वांट टू एक्सप्रेस देयर लव फॉर ईच अदर, सो उनकी क्या कहानी होगी?
Felt like it was meant to be when he talked to me about the concept. I really resonated.
You know, we'd started with the intention of like, you know, how exciting would it be if we made like a track in English and Pashto, right? But once her verse was in, I was like, I'm not even thinking about that anymore.
Intent hai, have a conversation with the world. Main, theek hai, aapse different hoon, lekin iska hargiz hi matlab nahi hai ki main aapke liye closed hoon.
Jwanzama, jwandasta, bela shanti de. हमारी ज़िंदगी और उनकी ज़िंदगी भले ही डिफरेंट हो, हर कले जख्म हम झड़पा दरवाजे, हम दिल के दरवाजे खोल के आपको वेलकम करते हैं कि आप आए हमारे साथ एक चाय तो पिए, फिर आपको मज़ा आएगा कि हम कैसे लोग हैं।
So he says welcome and I'm like, are you sure? Are you sure I can come in? Are you okay with that?
I find a similarity in both the languages. Pashto ka tandar aur wo basically English mein thunder hai. कुछ वर्ड्स थे जो सिमिलर थे, मैंने कहा ये क्या हो रहा है?
With all of that knowledge in mind, I came in and I sat with him and I made that bridge. We need hand claps, we need stomps, we need thunder, we need lightning, we need rain, we need like all of those things to come in, because like that just felt like, I just felt that so strongly.
First time we heard the song, the bridge section really stood out to us. Because there was this sound of thunder from there, and we started unpacking this concept.
Wow.
That started with this rain.
Each song doesn't just become about a song, but it becomes about an entire world that comes from that. From that language, from the people it's talking about, from the stories it's telling, from the lyrics that it's portraying. So that becomes much more than just a song.
वो शक्लें, वो आइडियाज़, वो लोग, वो सब कुछ ऐसा था कि आई वॉज वाउड।
लकी मरवत ट्राइब वॉज अ ह्यूज इंस्पिरेशन फॉर दिस। दोज पीपल लव्ड आर्ट एंड लव्ड म्यूजिक।
व्हेन यू हैव टू बिल्ड दैट वर्ल्ड, यू हैव टू बिल्ड दैट वर्ल्ड ऑथेंटिकली। आपके पास और कोई चॉइस नहीं है।
लोग कहाँ कहाँ से नहीं आए. यू नो वी हैड कास्टिंग पीपल हैव कम ऑल द वे अप फ्रॉम नॉर्थ. इट्स क्वाइट अमेजिंग टू सी दैट वी हैव सो मच डाइवर्सिटी इवन इन प्लेसेस वेयर वी डोंट फील दैट वी हैव डाइवर्सिटी.
बहुत खुशी है क्योंकि बहुत सारे इधर जितने भी पठान पार्टिसिपेट कर रहे हैं इसमें मुख्तलिफ इलाके से मुख्तलिफ ज़ुबानें बोलने वाले हैं.
यू ऑलवेज हियर स्टोरीज कि वो इतने हॉस्पिटेबल हैं इतने उनके मतलब प्यार से वो पेश आते हैं आपके साथ.
हर कले जो है वो तो खैर हमारा एक स्लोगन कह लो या मैनिफेस्टो कह लो पश्तूनों का. मेहमान होते ही बेसिकली ख़ास है वो अल्लाह की रहमत है. बेशक मैं गरीब हूँ या मेरा हुजरा छोटा है आपके रहने के लेकिन मेरा दिल बड़ा है. मैं आपको वेलकम कहता हूँ आप कभी भी आए.
लाइट
लाइट लाइट
I expected you guys to go above and beyond because that's just how Pakistanis do.
Everything is like from original, you know, like jahan se hum belong karte jis world se wahi scene hai.
The fact that it happened so quickly and the light, zabardast,
the effort and our DP,
amazing.
वॉइस कैसा लग रहा
है? ग्रेट मैन. आमिर इज अ विजार्ड. दिस इज आमिर्स वर्ल्ड एंड वी आर लिविंग इन इट.
लिटरली 3 2 1.
आवर जॉब इज लाइक हाउ कैन वी मेक श्योर दैट दिस डांसर लुक ब्यूटीफुल.
Dance is nice, just always make sure that the line is perfect.
That love and the art that we create here in Pakistan is so huge. It has potential to take over. That's why we're here. Until you tell them that you are a star, they will hide their magic.
So he's like distracted, right?
So we're not working with movements only, it's also choreographing their feelings.
Yeah. Oh, nice.
We want everyone to feel that feeling when you are part of creating something.
Yes. Sometimes we will work tight with the directors on the angle of the camera movements.
They're talking about their food. Nasi is foodie. The food is not so much spice, but it's so tasty.
Wow. Like they
how do you taste it?
Also, they stuff it with rice.
And keep it under.
Let's go eat.
एक अनार जो होता है वो बाहर से बहुत सख्त होता है बहुत नॉर्मल लुकिंग होता है लेकिन जब आप उसको खोलते हैं सो इट्स ऑलमोस्ट लाइक जूल्स इनसाइड. बेशक बाहर से हमें एक हार्ड शेल नज़र आता है एज आउटसाइडर्स बट अंदर कितनी खूबसूरती है. एंड जनरली द शेप ऑफ दिस स्पेस इज लाइक एन अनार जो ऊपर से खुला हुआ है.
This is a place where the community gets together in times of sorrow, in times of happiness, in times of strife.
With this concept, we're also establishing an arid, dry landscape on the outside. Under, we have this little oasis.
Yeah.
They have these traditions and nuances about their culture, joke most people like we didn't know about that.
जब बारिश नहीं हो रही थी बहुत देर से सो जो बच्चे होते हैं उनको घर में कोयला जो होता है या जो आपकी तवे की जो कालक होती है वो बना के वो मुंह पे लगाते हैं बच्चे और फिर वो घर से घर जाते हैं और जाके कहते हैं कि हम दुआ करेंगे बारिश हो.
और वहाँ पे हमें कोई गंदम दे रहा है कोई हमें चने के दाने दे रहा है तो हम सारे मिक्स लाते हैं और उसको हम उबालते हैं जिसको हम अपनी लैंग्वेज में गुंगड़ा ही बोलते हैं और वो आप सारे बच्चे खाते हैं शाम के वक्त फिर हम दुआ करते हैं बारिश के लिए.
जो वो हाथ का काम करते हैं मुझे जो नज़र आया वो ज़्यादातर तिल्ला था या डोरी का काम था. दे काइंड ऑफ लाइक मूव इट इन अ वे व्हिच इज़ वेरी यूनिक. मेरे लिए जो चैलेंज था वो ये था दैट हाशिम्स पैलेट ऑफ द सेट वाज वेरी अर्दी टोन्स एंड पख्तून क्लोज आर लाइक ब्राइट कलर्स जो औरतों के फ्रॉक्स के प्रिंट्स होते हैं शॉकिंग पिंक ग्रीन. So then you look for the prints, you look for the colors, you look for the material that's closest to theirs, but in a totally different extreme of colors, brown, beige, you know, moss green, very, very dull colors.
This guy dance. So the people in
dance sequence, we have like a talent deck that Shafia makes, and it makes it very easy for us. So we just look at the name and the sequence, and we just stitch it with it so that it's easier, because there's so many people and we don't want it to get confusing.
My whole idea was कि जब हम सेट पे जाएं, आपको लगता है कि आप किसी और दुनिया में पहुंच गए हैं. सो एवरी लिटिल एलिमेंट, क्लोथिंग, हेयर, मेकअप, सेट्स, दे ऑल निट द स्टोरी टुगेदर.
माय फेवरेट पार्ट ऑल इज स्लीप. सो इट्स नॉट अ चीप पीक स्लीप, इट्स द
फन. आई वांटेड हर टू फील गुड एंड मेक हर फील हैप्पी. दैट फीलिंग ट्रांसेंड्स इनटू देयर एक्सप्रेशन. When an artist is happy, you truly feel that you've done something. It was worth all the effort.
So true.
मुझे लिटरली ऐसा लग रहा था जैसे मेरा गांव है, सही है, बाहर बच्चे खेल रहे हैं. मेरी इमेजिनेशन वो जैसे ही मैं परफॉर्म कर रहा था उसका हिस्सा बिल्कुल बन गया था.
This is exactly what it feels like when you are removed from culture. You don't have something to hold on to, so you have to hold on to these little knickknacks like crystals or potions or your mom when she's trying to take off nazar from you and she's doing this thing like around you and burning red chili flakes. I resonated and it made me feel like I was at home. So it was so easy for me to like feel comfortable and perform at my fullest capacity.
Making it rain during a Coke studio performance, that was something a bit out there. I'm glad that we finally got to do it.
Wow. I can't.
How do you make it rain without all the wires and all the live equipment and everything getting
exactly
washed?
Ek music video mein jo ke live baj raha hai usme ye bhi ho raha hai. For me this was unbelievable.
It's supposed to look magical and mystical at the same time, and almost otherworldly and slightly foreboding. And slowly, slowly, with rain, you cleanse it, and you see, no, this is us as well.
Excellent! Very good.
What the world thinks about us because of what the world sees about us is not exactly who we are. Hamara art express karta hai ki hum people of love. बट जब वो हम फील करेगा सिर्फ हमारी वॉर्म्थ को, तो फिर उसे रहा नहीं जाएगा.
हमने बस वही कोशिश की जो आपने देखा नहीं है, जो आर्काइव था, जो फाइलें पीछे डस्ट में के अंदर पड़ी हुई थी, हमने वो केसेस बाहर निकाल दिए कि ये भी हम हैं.
मैं कहता हूँ ये दिन खत्म ही ना हो लिटरली, क्योंकि ये बहुत बड़ा दिन है मेरे लिए, बहुत बड़ा.
I always used to tell my mom that I wanted to be on Coke Studio. So I'm really grateful that I'm here in a moment where they want to welcome even people from the diaspora and remind you, like, even if you move all the way to Los Angeles, you're still a Pakistani. Welcome home, almost like that. That's what it feels like. Har kale.
Har kale. Har kale to everybody.
Amazing, wow. Amazing last shot. Wow. Oh, oh, oh man. Just
this one is just
this is
ye wale mein kuch aur kar diya unhone. You know, at the start of the season we were talking about what more will they do. This is the right trajectory of it, right? When somebody has mastered the emotional graph, the visual graph, the musicality of it, there is so much finesse in the way they've been doing things that we saw in last season itself. You know, when they transcended like kind of a genre, kind of a visual, whatever, they changed what they were doing and they did it so well that this mm-hmm. season they have taken that and gone deeper into it. Like, you know, deeper, literally almost to the point of probing that what more will we extract till love becomes the base. Because in anything in the world, like if, when you talk about emotions, the deeper you go, the deeper you go beyond the hurt, beyond the pain, beyond everything, under all of it, there's love. So how far are you willing to push yourself, your team, the whole vision, everything, till the point you reach that truest state, which is love? And I think they are managing to do that brilliantly so far. And this song, they have done it like, you know, kuch, wo jo magic ki baat ho rahi hai, wo magical kuch hua hai. चाहे वो बारिश के साथ है, चाहे वो लोगों के साथ है, चाहे वो कुछ हुआ है. एंड इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट थिंग टू लाइक काइंड ऑफ, वी कैन इंटेलेक्चुअलाइज इट अ लॉट एंड वी कैन पुट अ लॉट ऑफ नेम्स एंड वर्ड्स ऑन इट, बट देयर इज अ ह्यूमन एलिमेंट दैट दे हैव कैप्चर्ड इन दिस सॉन्ग, व्हिच इज इट्स लिटरली लाइक इट्स पोकिंग यू इन द हार्ट एवरी नाउ एंड देन, लाइक एंड इन द मोस्ट अनएक्सपेक्टेड प्लेसेस. लाइक इसमें जब वो बात कर रहे थे अबाउट यू नो द होल कहानी व्हिच दे स्पोक अबाउट, कि वो घर घर जाके राख मल के और घर घर जाके वो करते हैं. सो यहाँ पे जैसे लोहड़ी होती है, तो जहाँ पे आप लोहड़ी पे लिटिल बॉयज एंड गर्ल्स दे गो लोहड़ी लकड़ी एंड दे गो टू डिफरेंट हाउसेस एंड कलेक्ट लकड़ीज एंड देन दे काइंड ऑफ कम बैक फॉर फायर. नाउ इट मस्ट हैव इमर्ज्ड एट सम पॉइंट फॉर सम रीजन कि इतनी ठंड होगी उस टाइम सर्दियों में. सो सिमिलरली द थॉट दैट कनेक्टेड माय हेड वाज हाउ हंग्री दोज किड्स मस्ट बी एंड दोज फैमिलीज मस्ट बी और द कल्चर इन दैट टाइम दैट दे गो फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर सो ब्यूटिफुली, लाइक यू नो, एंड देन ऑल द फूड दैट कम्स टुगेदर, यू मेक इट टुगेदर टू सर्वाइव टुगेदर एंड टू ग्रो टुगेदर. It's just,
there are such little elements that hit your heart. What I'm seeing is, to carry on with the thought that, you know, they are taking things to that further step where finally all the probing leads you to a deep core of love, right?
Yeah.
And that is basically it. That is the basis of everything. So what I'm also seeing, because when you see a BTS like this and you see all the different people involved with the making of this one song, all the different departments that they cover through the BTS and all the human element behind that song, I just feel like it's one big ball of energy, you know? Yeah. It's all one big ball of energy that is just kind of, and like Zulfi said, we want to tell the world who we really are. We want to tell the world that we are misunderstood. What I am getting from all of that is people who are also deep down, there's a deep level of frustration also at probably the way things have been so far. Yeah. And that's why I feel like the whole country should be grateful for someone like Zulfi, who's like captaining the ship, because it takes that one person to take on the onus and direct things in a manner that has that intent, that has that message, that has that objective and vision that, you know, a lot has happened and a lot has been projected about us to the world.
What I got from the thing, even a lot what has been projected within the country about different
each
people.
Other yeah, yeah
each other
yeah
know?
So that's exactly the core of it, is that there is a frustration that has led to this thing happening in the way that it's happening, and it's not something that comes about overnight. It's years and years of a build up of that, then it's years and years of prepping and planning of how to break through that, and years and years of this team of mastering their specific crafts and arts, and then being able to collectively come together and being brought together to then say, no, we all collectively feel this frustration about the representation being off. Let's all come together. And I'm just seeing them as this one big ball of energy that is now on a mission to just, clear misconceptions and to just project the good that is in them to everyone. And you know, because intrinsically there is love in every human, you know, that they are dying to share and they are dying to give to someone, and that someone has to, you know, want that love as well. That, you know, that whole thing where she's asking that, can I be a part of it, are you sure? When someone hears that from someone, it doesn't matter what culture they're from or what language or what differences there are, but when someone is having that welcoming, like, can I come into your world, then it's like you will open your heart and you will let them in, you know, and everyone is waiting for that one person to ask, can I enter your world? So anyway, I'm just rambling now, but I feel like they are all of them. I see a team that is just so much energy and
I think it's taken a life of its own. Like in many places, maybe the team doesn't even realize what they are doing, but there is like a outside force that now this whole vision has taken, which is becoming bigger than what like, you know, what one is anticipating or expecting. Maybe only Zulfi knows. Because, you know, how ek end vision hota hai na, aur baki sab chal rahe ikatthe.
I don't think even he knows. They're so focused. They're like with blinders on, you know. They're so focused on what they want to create and get out as a message.
Yeah.
And as a presentation that they probably are reeling in the after effects after the feedback comes, you know, the comments that they get.
Oh, ye bhi hua, achha logo aise feel hua. Oh, you know, yeah.
Yeah, and also because remember in season 14, I remember him saying ki I was amazed ki har ek gana jo hum release kar rahe the, uske baad log us gaane ko leke us pe apni art dal rahe hain. Someone is making paintings, someone is creating covers, someone is
getting so inspired with clothes.
That are, yeah, so everyone's getting inspired in a different way out of it, and that they cannot anticipate themselves. So unko bhi itna wo lag raha hoga, but I feel like they are just blinders on and they're just at it doing their thing. Ab uska kya aayega aage jaake? But trust me, when you all are this, I can't get, sorry, let me finish my, you know, I realize I do this, I don't complete my thought and I move to the next one before I lose it. So say, if you're this focused on your intent and your vision and your mission, then there's no time to think about what the result will be. Then when it's out into the world and people have owned it and made it their own story, then you can just sit back and take it all in. So I think they're probably in that zone after every release. But my heart was like, I literally had goosebumps and, you know, watery eyes when I heard the Quick Style say that we are not just directing movement, we are directing feelings in the...
वो दिखता है वो इतना स्मूथनेस वो एक से दूसरी लय हो ही नहीं सकती इफ समबडी इज नॉट यू नो एक्चुअली बीइंग माइंडफुल ऑफ इट एंड डायरेक्टिंग इट
आई वाज इन ऑ ऑफ व्हाट ही सेड राइट देयर बिकॉज़ आई वाज लाइक दिस इज व्हाई एंड ही लिटरली देयर पीपल हु आर सिटिंग देयर एंड दे आर टेलिंग देम लुक लाइक दिस और गिव दिस एक्सप्रेशन और यू नो एंड दे आर नॉट इवन पीपल हु आर डांसिंग इट्स जस्ट अबाउट मेकिंग श्योर द फीलिंग इन दैट फ्रेम is what it's meant to be and it's supposed to be and it's not easy to bring out that feeling because they're not actors, they've been cast because they're from the region and they had casting and like full like auditions and all,
and that it should feel and look authentic even if somebody is putting it on, which is where direction and that kind of direction comes in,
and conversation because, I feel like they've probably made them feel like you pointed out in the first props to everyone who made them feel
correct
like they're in their own home
you know,
so
that comfort level.
And
you know the part where Zahoor and his friend, he said ki hum jab bhi Peshawar aate hain hum uski galiyon mein jaate hain, and ye wo, you know, they were talking about the whole thing and they were like, you know, just like how every two friends or more when they meet and when they get inspired and like business ideas start coming, and they were talking about that was hilarious. Immediate connection happens you know, because
Oh man, it was very cute. Different common bath, khane ki baate, khane ki baate, to matlab har jagah koi kaam kuch bhi ho raha ho, baat khane ki baate aa jati hai, and different kinds of foods, and I think we are all such foodies, right? Like the whole subcontinent ke sare log, matlab khane ki baate, not even a foodie, but the minute food comes anywhere, everyone's like, what is it, you know, happens. But coming back, because you mentioned foodie, I think Nasir, who was a foodie, he said this thing that, you know, until you tell someone they are a star, they will hide their magic. Oof.
Itni gehri aur sachi baat bol di na ke ye matlab ye bilkul sach hai.
Oof. Goosebumps. I was just like, this man is beautiful. It's just, you know, just the things he was saying in this BTS, I was just, you know, yes, you just, every human in the world is waiting for someone to recognize their spark and to just see their spark. And then you watch them come into their real persona and light up. Oof. If everyone just understood this one thing in the world and started highlighting the spark in every person they meet, then the world will be full of such happy, joyous people. Like literally, that's such an important truth. Oh, beautiful. Okay, so they have taken us, they've literally taken us into their world and just, you know, they were also saying ki hame khud lag raha hai ki hum hamare hi, you know.
Haan, ki kaise kiya? Listen, jo DOP hai, DOP ko to hats off. Lights and, you know, the ambience and the whole feel and the, oof, wow.
The art direction, the wardrobe, the makeup and hair, the, even like Saima, I think her name is, no, the makeup and hair, she was like, if we make them feel good and pretty or beautiful and like just, you know, the elements are all right, then they will perform in this.
You know, lights mein, I must point this out because of that moment, wow factor happened. आप मिजों से कैसे create करते हो कि एक बात कहीं नहीं गई लेकिन उसका एक बहुत ही छोटी सी बात से एक ऐसा कुछ हो गया है ना. There were these points when because वो बात कर रहे हैं कि बाहर बहुत गर्मी है and there's like a little oasis, like a little souk which is inside, which is like, you know, like where everybody comes together, culturally people like sit together, वो उसकी बात कर रहे थे. So if you noticed, most of the places, because it was all dark and all, and then light से उन्होंने patches create किए थे कि जहाँ पे धूप छन के अंदर आ रही है.
Yeah.
So that was so realistically done and it was all light. And the way it was done, it was almost like ke wo tavern ke andar baithe hain, ke ek souk ke andar baithe hain and ke bahar kitni garmi hai, ke itni sharp dhoop andar pad rahi hai. Yeah. You know, that moment, it was so real that the line between what is being created, what is real, how do you make something fake authentic, wo bahut lamba faasla hota hai. Lekin wo itni...
But I'm not even surprised because they've cracked this particular thing in every set and every video they've created.
You know, it hits you of course that much more. Wo ek ek wo dhakka lagta hai ki wah nikalta hai.
Yeah.
You know, those are the moments when wah happens. So I just needed to like this like kind of point it out.
But well, also see, they brought on cultural consultant Hidayat ji. Like yeah. Literally they were like, no, we ourselves are unaware of so much of the nuances and details of this land and this region and the people. We need someone on board.
I think they're doing that for every song, hai na?
But I feel first
for the photographer
written in a way like this, you know,
like that
culture
okay.
consultant, and then he was in the
about to switch. Because,
so like the first time I've seen it written like a culture consultant, and then he was in the BTS talking about and so many things he highlighted. So I feel like even the Coke Studio team and the Co team, they are also on this whole cultural awareness journey, you know. Along with the rest of us. So the first kind of inspiration point, starting point becomes Zulfi, who's like, okay, now we're going to go into this region, right? Sound of the Nation. So we're now, it's kind of becoming clear to us that every part of Pakistan and every language and all that will be sort of showcased to the world. So now the decision has been made, okay, we'll go here to this area this time. Then everyone else on the team is like, oh, okay, what do we know? Not a lot. Then we have the culture consultant come in, and then we have this also. So everyone is
and
like,
how for
you
the
know,
Sindhi song, they had that photographer who came in.
Exactly.
Maybe not for Magrola, because Magrola was like more, they all kind of knew
they all
language
are in their,
and
yeah.
the cultural thing. Correct.
It was all their thing. So I'm just, you know, it's very cute because everyone is, while they are experts at what they're doing and creating, they're also in learner mode. On the other
and
side.
That's, I think, the exciting part.
So
no?
Beautiful.
Yeah, it's really nice. Yeah,
it's because that learner childlike energy is also there in all of these people who are
it's too good. Too
considering.
Good.
So I think that is beautiful to see because then you're constantly also, you're taking all that thing you're learning and then you're applying it. It's just, you know, the end result is just so nice. So, okay, that is happening. So like you saw Viru, I distinctly looked at the smile on her face when Zulfi was telling her the narrative and the concept of the song. She was just like sitting there with a smile on her face and she had this particular like sparkle in her eyes, which she was connecting so much with what he was saying that it was like, you know, we are different from you. It's a good thing. But beyond the differences is this, you know, other thing. So I was like, I think that expression of hers kind of for me captured what the team must have felt. They must have been like, okay, we like this. So then, okay, so this guy, then I'm just quickly scrolling through so we don't miss any element. Him talking about his like, the ties with Peshawar, but also how it was just a discovery of one video that made Zulfi call him.
And what a song that is.
Yes.
Like, what a video.
Can
I want to check it out immediately.
Yes, please share the link in the comments. We want to listen to it because what a catchy song. It was so fun. And that's why when I heard it, I was like, okay, no wonder the language sounded so beautiful to us. It is. It's a vibe.
Yeah,
it was very cute. So that
and the cultural songs don't sound like that. So it's his own rhythm or this new age music that's going on in the region currently, which is like, you know, the new kids who are like now growing up and are like, let's get those influences in the Pashto thing.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Yeah. And it also made me think like, it started with Zulfi seeing that video of the dancers from that region and saying, look at them, they're representing their culture. This is amazing. We have to highlight this and show this. Yeah. Then he spotted this guy in his song in a random video. So my thing is, guys, just put your content out there. Don't think, you never know when someone will find it and spot you and a beautiful thing will get created out of it. And I think
especially the authentic ones. Like, yes. You know, even if you're doing cover versions, but you're good, just put it out there.
Yeah. Like Rema was sitting and singing in LA and imagine her desire to be on Coke Studio must have been so strong all her life and growing up. She used to tell her grandmother, she said, right? Just put your stuff out there. You don't know. It'll all come together. It'll all sync.
This kind of also reminded me that how there are certain elements jo inke har season mein thode thode ho rahe hain. Like how with last season, Aruj Aftab, like, you know, they, when she kind of came in and then it was like this different sound, but yet like, you know, representation of their country, but from different countries, like NRIs were living, NRIs nahi, inke toh kya hue? The Pakistanis were living, haan, who are living like out of the country. Unke, waise.
Yes, I wanted to talk about that because I was just like, I can see why she related to it because, so I've been a diaspora child my whole life also. And it's not like, and it's not some, sorry, we had a bit of a gimbal situation. It's okay. But as I was saying, so her thing, I really connected and resonated with her because also have been a diaspora child. And my whole thing, where she was saying that, you know, we live so far away also, but still we are, you know, from the same land. And I felt like her Kale was like a welcome home. Yeah. And I was, and when she was saying that, I think she was saying somewhere in the start that, you know, I've always, I've been away. So I don't know if I'm a part of the thing. I also sing in English and all of that. So I was like, you know, there have been so many times in my life. And I feel like Gulf kids are unique because we don't grow up very far from India. And a lot of us grew up in Indian schools, you know. Right, so it's not like we didn't learn Hindi and we didn't learn our languages and we didn't speak that. So when I've lived in the US and when I've lived in Europe and the UK and when I've lived in India, I have seen... and I have faced so many situations where when I'm in India, I will be too NRI for them. You know, I'll be not in our circles, but generally or like at work or like other places where I have to mingle, I'll be too much of a, okay, I don't feel like I'm part of the world. I'm still a little. And then when I've been in the US, for example, I didn't feel like I connected very strongly because I was like, okay, we're all Indian, but y'all like, I can't crack my Hindi jokes with y'all. Y'all don't understand. They, because they only speak English. Like my own cousins, they didn't speak Hindi. They grew up with English and just Gujarati. So anyway, so it's the feeling of being from somewhere but still not feeling like you belong is not a lot of
it's
us.
A real thing.
It's a real thing, and I think I've even heard artists who say that when I move back. It was like you're not one of us because you're very different. You've grown up, so you speak differently, you talk differently, you have an accent, all those things happen. And then when you go that side, you also don't feel like you belong because
That happens within states also, just to let you know. Like from one state to other when you move, or from one school to a different school when you move and you don't have friends, like, you know, or like even like area wise that happens. So I think it's but I hear what you're saying, that magnifies a lot more, especially when you're like, you know, off one culture and you don't live there and then you come back and you feel displaced. Like there's this like strong sense of displacement.
When you're a third culture child, it's very difficult to find a space where you feel completely at home. Yeah. It's actually not possible to find it because in the whole world, where is that? That place doesn't exist.
Correct.
Your third cultureness doesn't exist anywhere. It's not a physical place. So you will always feel a little bit of like a little bit of an outsider everywhere. So I saw someone say this very beautifully somewhere in some comment somewhere, that as a third culture child, I feel like I can fit in everywhere, but I don't belong anywhere. And it just hit my heart. I was like, oh God. Because we know certain nuances and things about, so we can fit in.
Correct.
We can bond and we connect and we make friends easily and all of that happens. But do we really that line?
I hear you.
So I really, like, resonated with what she was trying to say and said also in this BTS. And it was really nice when she said it felt like a welcome home. Very sweet, very cute. So okay, that happened. Listen, I was just scrolling through those two kids, who were smiling at the camera.
All of them were smiling. Which one?
No, when they were in Peshawar in this guy's BTS, those two kids. But by the way, she's singing in the mountains. I think it was a live Instagram, like beautiful voice, the way it was echoing in that surrounding. Okay, so that
happened in the BTS. Did they speak about that? How if they went to some place for the opening shot and stuff? So maybe those were stock images, or maybe they were images generally representing the place.
I feel wo aega Instagram wale BTSs mein, because in this, and I've noticed this in the Magical Journey, they tell the people ka story. people behind the song. The technical things they put out later on Instagram of each department.
Yeah, so smart. Because कितनी बातें बताओगे ना BTS में भी. That also cannot just exceed like endless
18 minutes.
Whatever.
Yeah. Then it'll become a 40-minute, 1 hour.
And that gets too much. Like you know, too much information. Yeah.
I find that so wo aayega, wo Instagram pe aayega. We'll keep a lookout for it. Like the art department, the costumes, they all have BTSs on Instagram.
I've been checking out. I'm up to date, except this song. I'm up to date on all of it.
No, I have sporadically seen, but I have to watch them in sequence. Okay, she's ahead of you. Okay. But I found the cutest bit is when she's like, "Main Urdu mein nahi ga pati, abhi mere ko pashta bhi aa raha hai," that he's teaching her the lines. You saw her face when you're looking at the screen. So
that face summed it up. That essay like, face? Yeah, that summed it up.
That was hilarious. So fun. So this is what, like, the whole human element. And then one second, Abdullah Siddiqui was there. And what he was saying, that whole,
he basically in one line answered everything we were asking about the rain, about the everything. Wo ek simple se do line mein usne sab kuch bata diya, and I was like, okay, got it.
So that bridge section also, and the thunder and all the effects. You know, Abdullah Siddiqui ka wo first song jo tha Nescafe mein that we had seen, in that itself, you know, with the laser beam harp and all that whole situation that was happening. How beautifully imaginative his mind is what I think, you know? Like,
I listen to all his songs quite a lot. Like, they're it's something else. Like,
something else.
You know, dimaag ki galiyon mein aap thoda thoda se ghoomke, fir thoda sa recognize karna shuru karte ho ke, achha, haan, you know, this is his zone, this is his type, this is like whatever, like,
And also, I note, Zulfi said that he noticed a similarity in both the languages in terms of certain words being
even
the same.
In English, mein he said, like, the thunder word and or something like that is similar.
Yeah.
How amazing is that?
Amazing. It just amazes me how these things are all, they all exist in the world and we are all just unaware, and how research can dig out these.
Yeah. Now to with this whole genetic, whatever, like, you know, you can decode.
Tracing.
Genetic decoder, huh? And the tracing thing. Usme sab pata lag jata, like, aisi aisi baat hai. Like, you know, there were so many moments when they were speaking in Pashto and I was remembering my grandfather. Because you used to talk about a lot of such things, like, you know, and I was like, it sounded so familiar. And I was like, so I mean, I was really young when I, like, you know, last met my grandfather, but like, unki kya life rahi hogi, kya baatein, you know, that little elements of it till date we remember. So it is just, it's gorgeous.
Different,
like,
words.
You know, yeah, what, it's a little strange to like just know.
It unlocks a certain box of memory in your mind.
Yeah.
These things.
Which is not my memory. Which is like a genetic memory. It is not my memory.
It's so probably true.
Yeah,
that's true.
So it's a very it's a beautiful feeling. It's a strange feeling.
Mm.
It's a very humanizing feeling, and it's very like connected feeling. Like, you know, when you feel connected to the whole world, vaise. And I think that's the bottom line message of it all.
That, you know, so these concepts that you have in movies like Avatar and all of that, that everything is connected. And by the way, I just finished watching Demon Slayers. I don't know, my first anime. Usme, wo dreams mein, ya apne visions mein, they're seeing something and they're like, oh, I've seen this before. But it's not that lifetime's memory. And they know that that memory is coming from a different, like, you know, jinka khoon aap mein beh raha hai, unki memory se attached hai.
Genetic memories,
so it is exactly this. So it's all, anyway, we are digressing. But bhavnaon ko samjho.
Nahin, but main bata rahi hun. Maine recently ek reel dekhi thi. Aur usme wo explain kar rahe the ke how jo normally desert area se genetically born children and people hote hain, unko kitna bhi kuch kar lo, wo din mein 1.5 liter se zyada pani nahi pi payenge, because unki genetic coded memory wo hai. So all this new fad which is going on, no, you have to drink this much liter of water, itna to peena hai, not everybody's body is meant for it, and not everybody should drink it. You know, it's each person's genetic code and a genetic memory that also carries forward. I'm not saying don't drink water. I'm saying drink water. But according to...
Now I'm using this excuse every time my father says you're not drinking water.
Pehle apni heritage check karo, uske baad ye excuse maar raha.
I'm just going to use it. What the hell? It's okay. I'll also, when she says eat bengan, I'll be like, no, it's not in my genetic memory. My genetics don't allow it to like...
I have given excuse worthiness now.
I love it. Thank you. It is. Okay, everyone, use that excuse. We have newfound ammo. Okay, so then they were showing us all the elements or all the different guys from that they've cast in the video from there, and all these like snapshots
with their hair and Barish, and then like flicking their hair. I was like, that right there.
वही वाला लाइक मूव्स एंड थिंग्स दैट दे वर डूइंग दैट मेड अस फील दैट कंप्लीट अबैंडन एंड and freedom and all of that surrender you know to the moment but I found those things that these guys were talking about that hame bhi nahi pata tha ye sab cheeze and the actual like zoom in that they went into that one area ka people they are people who love art and music so much they used to sell their bakri and sheep to buy that transistor
it's just like
beautiful so it's deeply ingrained you know It's amazing.
I'm being quiet because मैं वापस रोना शुरू कर दूँगी नहीं तो like ये जो चीज़ है ना like it hits me like you know as people who love music as people who are in the industry like you know we go get mics and we go get equipment and we go get everything and like
Speakers
you know
and
yeah like just everything and यहाँ पे मतलब एक सिंपल सी चीज लाने के लिए एक ट्रांजिस्टर बैक इन दैट डे वो बोल रहे बूम बॉक्स वगैरह वो लाने के लिए मतलब सोचो वो क्या क्या एफर्ट करते थे It is just suddenly makes you be very grateful mm-hmm. and very appreciative of their journey as well mm-hmm. and appreciative of like, it's just...
Yeah, it's just beautiful. I think these kind of like simple things, like the love for music and dance, it is such a basic human characteristic, you know?
Yeah.
It's there in like... Can you think of anyone who hates music or doesn't like it? There must be people...
Unless they have some form of trauma.
Yeah. No.
The basic human spirit cannot because we're all made of music, right?
Unless
like I firmly
some...
believe that. So unless unko koi trauma hua hai, which is then an exceptional case, like
no.
you know, alag wo ho jata hai.
No.
But it is impossible. Otherwise,
it is impossible. So again, like these, like it comes down to the core of it. It's just beautiful. It's all we're all connected in these similarities. So yeah, I mean, listen, these guys when Nasir and Bilal, the way they were directing them, I can't. That one line won my heart. They will hide their magic till you don't tell them. You're a star. All are stars. Just say. They were
yes, Joe, you're a
feeling.
Star. Shine. Come out of your shell.
वो तो क्या last season में हो गया इसे तो मैं रोती हूँ. All their comments. So no, it's also choreographing their feelings. We're not working just with movement. We're choreographing feelings. This. thing when he said it I was like yes wo dikh raha tha aur wo dikhta hai it's beautiful that y'all are going so deep into what you're doing that it's like it's not you know it's not superficial top layer at all it's so this thing
yeah
they're all balls of energy and then I'm going that whole story about the kids with the coal this thing beautiful and how the I really like props to the costume this Fatima and Saima the way they had to work with like the neutral colors of the set and the whole design and then it's like imagine they have to find these prints or create them and then
the hair of it which was lying on that long table and how they were mixing matching it that was just brilliant
yeah absolutely it's just everyone's So beautiful. Okay. And that Nazar, so that was Nazar Utar.
It was, huh?
Yeah.
When they said it, I was like, oh.
Wo mirchi burn kar rahe the aur wo sage ya jo both hai, usko burn kar rahe the. Very nice. So, okay, lovely. I'm just quickly scrolling. I just love the end shot. How they started the BTS with that footage of those dancers and how they ended it with them doing it on the set and then camouflaging it and mixing
that
it.
That cut, that transition was phenomenal.
Kya rap kiya hai.
Editor person, take a bow. That one was like money shot hota na jo waise wala type ka tha wo.
Absolute mint. Love it. So okay, BTS produced by O Dimension. Is it O or Zero? O Dimension. Producer Moiz Kazi, Amna Makbul, Faiz Kazi, Moiz and Saif and Moiz. Okay, amazing. BTS subtitles and translations, Simran Sablani. Props to you as well. Beautiful. These BTSs are just full-fledged documentaries. In fact, this should just go on like a streaming platform or something, you know, season.
Maybe that's the plan in future.
Maybe.
Because ye in this day of, you know, quick content creation, like abhi jo itna sabko yaad hai, do you really think even, forget 5 years down the line, even 3 years down the line, not everybody will recall. People like us will recall, you know, but then there'll be newer generations who have come in who would be like, nahi pata. Exactly. So...
And who should see.
Yeah. So I think putting it all on like one of those platforms or later, uska ke kya journey thi, kaise hota tha. I think it is just like content after content, which keeps recycling. When something good gets created, it's content for life. Then
for
depending
life.
On, you know, usko kaise, what jacket you put on it. And
it's part of everyone's legacy. Can I also add, like, this is y'all's legacy. ब्यूटिफुल ओके
जाने का मन नहीं करना ना
ये आई नो आई डोंट वांट टू लीव द वर्ल्ड एंड जस्ट लुक एट द एंड दे वर ऑल डांसिंग Oh, the rain. We must talk about the way the rain element of it. First of all, when it started raining, the first thought in my head was like, the mics, the wires.
Wires,
I hope nobody gets...
Set ke andar barish kaise kara di? Correct.
Like, and then I was thinking, ki iske kitne takes liye honge ya ek take mein hi ho gaya. You know, that is a thought that I'll continue to have till somebody from the team answers it.
Because, and live action mein barish ki awaaz bhi aa rahi thi.
Yeah.
And I think that's what was part of it and required as well. So how they were also talking about, so did you notice BTS में उन्होंने ये सवाल पूछ लिए और ये वही सवाल थे जो हमारे सवाल थे like you know generally सबके सवाल हैं लेकिन answer नहीं किया very smart बताया नहीं कि like कैसे how they hopefully in one of those reels like you know they share that how they managed it
yeah because you know in even in like last season they've done many takes you know it's not yeah. like एक take में हुआ है
तो लेना पड़ेगा final take
तो मैं वही सोच रही हूँ कि उनका कपड़े तो भी गए
I think वो blue जो है उसके नीचे My take of it is कि नीचे wires के ऊपर blue color का ऐसे वो जो plastic होता है उसके ऊपर paint and clay and all that से they must have जैसे लेपी करते हैं ना then created that on top so that it looks like a solid structure and on that barish that is my take
both तो हो सकता है because if they're doing multiple takes they have to remove that water and make it all dry again
वो तो drainage system लग सकता है
Yes. But my thing is in that space where the barish is happening the only electronic thing are their two mics The other equipment is outside the barish zone.
Correct.
So, itna stress nahi hai. Meko wo lag raha tha ki mic, haan, wo hold kar rahe the. So, my thing was, have the mics been waterproofed? Because imagine the singers are singing and they get electrocuted. It's not a very nice thing. Anyway, so that was the thing. And the only thing they didn't answer is, isme kitne takes aapne liye hain? Because unke kapde wapde sab bheeg gaye na. They're standing there.
Multiple takes. I'm sure multiple takes honge. My, like, I still want to know. Yeah.
What so every time they have to then dry themselves off, dry the clothes off, do the hair and makeup again?
That is just for that single first shot. When gile se wo usme ja rahe hain. Because then, once you're gila, then you can take multiple shots na. Phir to aap gile hi ho.
No. When they are not gila.
That is just one shot.
Yeah.
Wo to ek hi hota hai.
I know. But I'm saying if they are only like recording start to end in one take, the whole song, or did they do that bit... Okay, these are all unanswered questions. We are going to overthink till the cows come home. But let's not. If someone from the team can tell us.
We're just giving questions so they can create reels out of it and maybe answer. That's what's happening.
Exactly. I'm giving you content ideas. I'm sure they've already made it to this. Just saying. Yeah, anyway, would love to know and love that everyone jumped into the middle and started dancing at the end. Hells yeah. Chalo, we have to leave this. We have to end. So
beautiful. Thank you for this song. Thank you for making, you know, going to the tail. Up till love. Thank you for that.
So needed. And it's just heartwarming to see that there is a team that is so dedicated to this mission of connecting people, no matter what their differences. Beautiful. Yeah. So thank you. And we'll see you guys in the next song. And
oh, one thing we didn't mention, the sleeves. That was hilarious. She kept doing the sleeves.
Beautiful.
Right
Her outfit deserves special mention. Beautiful. Sleeves. First of all, it's my favorite green and the work on it and that.
The sleeves. Okay, bye. The sleeves.
I also want. They should now. That shop is needed. Now even I want to shop. Okay, chalo. On that note, take care of yourselves. Live long and prosper.